Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will see how to fix if you cannot mount ISO file in your Windows 10. So first we will see how this problem occurs and then we will see the solution. But before that, here is a small recommendation. If you are first time on my YouTube channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to receive notification about my new videos. Alright, so let us see how this problem actually occurs. So here I have an ISO file and if I double click on it, I get this error, sorry, there was a problem mounting the file, could not mount the file. And if I double click on it again, I receive the same error. So if you are also facing this same problem on your system, we will see how you can fix it. First of all, make sure that you are not using the ISO file shortcut to mount. Second suggestion is to unblock the ISO file from its properties. So right click on the ISO file and select properties, and in the general tab, check mark the unblock option. And the final suggestion is that you need to make sure that ISO file is not corrupted. How you can ensure that? You can download it from the official source again. And in case if these suggestions didn't help you, here is the another registry solution you can apply. Right click on the start button and select run, type REGEDIT and press the enter key. In the USC confirmation prompt, click yes. Now in the registry editor window, if you are on the newer Windows 10 version, you can directly go to this registry key by pasting its location directly from the video description I have provided. If you are on the earlier version of Windows 10, you can simply go to this registry key step by step. For example, H key, local machine and then system and so on. In the right pane of the final registry key, which is actually a GUID, you will find lower filters and upper filters named registry strings. All you need to do is right click on them and select delete. You will see a confirmation prompt. So click on yes in that and delete these two values. And once you delete these registry strings, you can simply close the registry editor and reboot the system to make changes effective. So after restarting the system, we will check if the problem is resolved. So I am again in the file explorer and I will try to mount the file and see if the problem is resolved. So as you can see that this time the error did not occur and the file is successfully mounted, and I can simply click on the setup file to initiate the upgrade of a version. In this way, the issue has been resolved. So thanks for watching this video. If you found it helpful, do like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos.